Hello and welcome to the Wachendorf Projektor Tool tutorial. Today we will learn how to create a meter object, how to configure it, and how to reference a variable to the object. As a basic, we'll use a project resulting of the tutorial create and download project file. First, open the home page of the project. Then find meter object in the object palette on the right side. Then drag and drop it into the frame. You can replace it inside of the frame and you can resize it. Now our meter object is created. Let us look at its properties. You can find them here on the right side of your window. So far, any graphical object is selected in preview or in your projector tree. Its properties will be highlighted here. All object properties are grouped and listed always in the same order, from general to specific. General properties are object name, size, and location. These properties follows variable reference. Connecting object to the variable, we will reach that this object becomes dynamic, so it will show the value of the variable during the runtime. For the meter, this will mean that its needle will move. So far, the variable will change. There are two ways how you can connect a variable to your object. The first one is using this field. Press on this button and select here the owner of your variable, its group, and the name of the variable itself. So far you click on OK, the variable will be connected to your object. Another option is to use the variable view here. You will need to find your variable here in your table. Let us use now the variable for display backlight intensity. Drag and drop it to your object and select variable reference. As you see in your table, the value is also there. Skin properties describe the optical parts of your object, such as background color or image, if the border should be drawn or not, and if your object should be transparent or not. Visibility property connects the object to the trigger that make it visible or invisible to the runtime. This trigger is a part of the predefined internal variable for visibility. Now we are coming to input configuration. Set as input means making possible that the object can be selected and its value can be changed by encoder. Connected to encoder means that this will be the only object on this page which can be changed and selected by encoder. Let us now look at meter-specific properties. For now, our meter object uses the full circle. For our sample, we will change it using only this part of it. To do it, we will configure start and end angles of the object. Let us look how to do it. The spanning direction of the meter object area is always counterclockwise, independent of how the direction of the needle should be. The angles we have are here and here. If we will take this angle as a start angle and this as an end angle, our meter area will be like this, and all the rest will become transparent. For our sample, we will need to exchange them. So our start annual will be this one, and our end annual will be this. Resulting, we will have this meter area, and all the rest area will become transparent. Back to our projector tool. The deflection direction defines how the needle should work. Here you can set the needle color, and you can also use a needle image. Needle image should be prepared, and it should be squared. The direction of the needle on the image should be on 3 o'clock. You can define if you'd like to draw arc or not. The same is for ticks. Let us now look at value-related properties. They are connected to the reference variable. Here, the absolute maximum value and absolute minimum value defines the range of the referenced variable and will also be connected to start and end annuals we just defined. Minimum and maximum values separate this whole range into three different parts. In these three parts, the needle color will be changed. You can also see it in this image. Your whole range is between absolute minimum and absolute maximum. In between, you have a values of minimum and maximum. Here, in between, the color of your needle will be defined by the property needle color. Here, the color below minimum will be used, and here, the color about maximum. It is important that your absolute minimum value should always be smaller as your minimum value, your minimum should be smaller as maximum value, and your maximum value should be smaller as absolute maximum value. Now you know which properties are available for the meter object. To get the sample completed, use the following values for your meter. The meter object in your first project is now ready.